This time, we are in the Dead Sea. There's no other place like it on Earth.
Get some good treatments. Very nice. Get younger skin.
Yeah. Feel much younger already.
A lot of important events in history took place in this very region. So in the next four episodes, we will explore the place where the ancient Israelites have crossed over to the Promised Land for the first time and the place where Jesus was baptized by John the Baptist. We will explore the Qumran caves where most ancient Hebrew manuscripts were found and learn about the community of scribes who wrote them. We will also explore Masada, a fortification on top of an isolated rock plateau, and how it relates to King David.
So we're hiking down from Masada on a snake path or a snake road, that's what they call it.
In this episode, we start with the geographical epicenter of all these events, the Dead Sea. Are not that many roads that can take you to the Dead Sea nowadays. In fact, there are only two. Road 1 that goes through Jerusalem, or Road 90 that goes through the West Bank. Driving from Nazareth, it would have taken us 4 hours if we had taken the Jerusalem route. So we drove through the West Bank. The scenery is quite different than what we're used to up north. It is breathtaking. As we descended lower and lower into the lowest road on earth, we could feel our ears pop.
This is the lowest land on earth. This is the lowest boulevard on earth. Do you smell that sulfuric smell?
There is a strong smell because there's hamamot somewhere. I am walking on salt, literally. We are at the Dead Sea and underneath me, a lot of salt accumulated and became like part of the beach. It is so hard. It's like walking on hard ice. But look how beautiful the water is and the color. And if you touch it, it's like touching oil from all the minerals that it has. Wonderful place.
The Dead Sea is the saltiest body of water on Earth. In fact, it is 9.6 times saltier than the ocean. It is so salty that nothing lives in it, not a single fish or a living organism. But on the bright side, because of the salt level, even if you try, you kind of can't really sink. You'll simply float on top of it.
Now, why were we running?
Why were we? Yeah, that's a good question.
Okay.
What are you doing?
Hydration, very important.
The Dead Sea has a big problem. In recent years, the water has been receding at an alarming rate. It is so much smaller than when I was here 20 years ago. The dry shores started cracking, and there is danger of sinkholes everywhere. So in 2018, Jordan will begin the Red Sea, Dead Sea Water Conveyance Project. The idea is to take water from the Red Sea and bring it up to the Dead Sea. The cool part is that it was possibly prophesied in Ezekiel 47, verse 8, where it describes the Dead Sea becoming fresh and having fish from the Great Sea live in it.
Yeah.
So we hope you enjoyed this episode. Please subscribe below if you liked it. If you didn't, still subscribe, or else Rhoda will, like, I don't know, send you salt from the Dead Sea.
Here, speaking of that, on your face.
Thank you.
Get some good treatment.
Very nice.
Get younger skin.
Yes.
Yeah.
Feel much younger already.